Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, no obese Boy Scouts allowed. That is the latest rule in the quadrennial Boy Scout Jamboree that opened in West Virginia yesterday. Scout leaders designed the 10-day wilderness gathering in the New River Gorge region, and it's the most physically demanding event for the group since the first Jamboree held at the Washington Monument back in 1937.
Wow.
To be eligible for this year's mass gathering, tens of thousands of scouts and their leaders have to meet the standards for the body mass index, as well as other health factors. The group's director says this is a new requirement that, quote, has motivated an enormous return in terms of both kids and adults getting serious about improving their health. But what if you're that kid and you're the one kid in the group? You're the one kid in the group in your group that doesn't get to go.
I love that kid.
Yes, we all know. It happens. I could be that kid. Everybody was going to be that kid.
You know what? Stand up and you just go anyway.
Yes.
That's what I say.
So what if you're the one kid who everybody else is packing their bags and they're all going for this great weekend and you're stuck back at home going, oh, okay, I'm too heavy to go. Doesn't that mess you completely up?
But you have to think of the other side of that. Yeah. Let's say that kid does go and for some sort of health reason, something happens.
Right.
How mad are those parents for... You know, they're of course then going to jump down the throats of the troop leader saying, why did you even allow my child? You should have told me up front what this requires. You should have given him some sort of physical assessment, which I think that's what all they're trying to do. They're not lying. They're saying this is kind of a grueling outing.
Right.
Right. We want to make sure that anyone going on this is safe and will stay safe throughout.
But that doesn't mean they have to say, you know, X to certain people. They can put all those guidelines out there, and then that's where the parents have to get super involved and
sign a waiver, stay in constant
communication, right. Talk to the doctor. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just like anything else. You know, everybody should get a fair chance, in my opinion, to be able to get out there and, you know. I think it's a great message to say, like, hey, why don't you try it? Maybe you're overweight or something, and but let's lose those pounds. This is a great way to do that.
Yeah. Get a letter from your from the kid's doctor or something like that, saying, hey, the kid's healthy. You know, there are other huge events like this that have many more people than this, and they've got medical tents set up, and they're always prepared. Look, I thought the Boy Scouts were supposed to be prepared. Be prepared.
Oh, burn.
I'm assuming, though. They're saying tens of thousands of scouts go to this.
Right.
I could be in the best shape of my life and get bit by something, stung by something.
So
I could turn an ankle the wrong way.
That's true.
I'm sure there has to be medical staffing there.
Yeah, you don't want to be that one kid sitting at home. That's all.
Yeah.
I hope so. Just go anyway.
Go.
Well, here's what some of our Facebook friends are saying and Twitter followers. Sherry Wilmer tells us, my son's in the Scouts. That's not what I thought scouting was all about.
Right.
They're actually discriminating based on weight. I'm very discouraged by this.
Especially this day and age, there's a lot of kids overweight.
Jamie Mark states, absolutely disgusting. Every child deserves a fair chance.
Mm-hmm.
Right there with you. Daniel Sullivan says, way to exclude the ones that could probably use a little outdoor activity.
Just like you said, Meg.
Yeah. Andrew Gothberg weighs in and says, I'm a former Boy Scout and I'm handicapped. I had no rules or regulations against me of any sort. Things that have changed in this country for various reasons over the past 10 or so years are absolutely insane.